in the context of the record, the Seldom Seen Kid is a sort of gentle way of referring to our friend Brian, who died during the making of the record. He was a singer-songwriter from Manchester who was a very dear friend of ours. So the Seldom Seen Kid is just referring to Brian, really, just a way of gently dedicating the record to him, because he was great.
One, two, three, four.
Working on a cocktail called Grounds for Divorce. Whoa, polishing a compass that I hold in my sleeve. Whoa,
Grounds for Divorce, though, the actual riff, Potter's just been playing that for years and years and years. It's never gone on anything or anything like that.
The song's really about wanting to change everything, wanting to get out of Manchester, wanting to get out of the relationship. It's just pointing a critical finger at my beloved Manchester.
There's a hole in my neighbourhood down which of late I cannot help but fall.
We've written an awful lot of music for this album. I think the songs are probably about everything that all five of us have been through in the last 2.5 years. So, yeah, as always, light and shade, you know. We're quite often asked if we're sort of envious of contemporaries of ours that have outsold us 10 to 1, and more than that, 100 to 1.
A 1,000 to 1.
You know what I mean? There's plenty of our contemporaries that have sold a lot more records than us. But then again, there's plenty of our contemporaries who've been and gone.
There's this whispering of jokers doing flesh by the pound to a chorus of supposes and the little town horns. There'll be twisted karaoke at the Anisee Lounge. And I'll bring you further roses, but it does you no good. And it does me no good. And it does you no good. There's a hole in my neighborhood down which of late I cannot help but fall. There's a hole.
We've been very lucky, we've never really been slated. I've no doubt somebody will do at some point. Make a name for themselves as a journalist by flying in the face of public opinion, but it'll probably have a rock and roll name. I hate it when journalists have rock names, do you know what I mean? I haven't changed my name to Jeff Zapp, you know what I mean? Or Johnny
Spacedust.
Where did that come from?
I don't know.
Johnny Spacedust, lead singer of Elbow. You know what I mean? Fuck off. Being on a tour bus sometimes like living on a submarine, but we kind of know each other well enough to know when to give each other room and to support each other. But as for genuinely caring about each other, no, it's too late for that shit.
What's that?
Video camera.
Is it?
I mean, we've played pretty much everywhere, really.
We're not playing Carnegie Hall.
Where's that?
Carnegie Hall's in New York, isn't it?
What was that great one we did with Doves?
The Hammerstein Ballroom.
Yeah.
Because I missed the opportunity of a lifetime. During the first song, I was going to go, stop, Hammerstein. And I didn't.
Didn't do it. Should have done it.
Should have done it.
Got that.
Regret. Some writer, I thought at the time I was writing that song about a friend of ours who was drinking too much. And I realised that you're asking for advice, but you don't want to admit it's for you. You sort of say, this friend of mine's got a problem, this friend of mine. I realised I do that all the way through the song. And I think subconsciously, perhaps I was talking about myself. A friend of mine grows his very own brambles. They twist all around him till he can't move. A beautiful quivering shivering shambles. What is my friend trying to prove? Our stuff's been described as melancholy, and I'd agree with that. But I think that's just where all of our musical tastes clash.
I think that's where we're at our best as well, isn't it? I think that kind of melancholy sort of stuff is where we're strong.
Very strong.
Very strong.
Like an ox.
Cos it's breaking my heart, it's breaking my heart. It's breaking my heart to pour like the rain. Start singing again. When will my friend start singing?
How many slices of beef you got in there?
Four.
Four slices of beef, four slices of pastrami. I'd say that was excessively meaty. The best way to remain best friends with everyone in Elbow is to bring him their lunch every day, which is something I do. Pete starts thinking about his dinner while he's eating his breakfast. I'm not being unfair there,
no,
am I?
No, I do.
I remember hearing Pete on the phone once, and you were going, have some of that chicken that you had yesterday, and... if you've got any rocket, some lettuce, a little bit of salt, a little bit of pepper, and then can I have a layer of English mustard? No, just a layer of English mustard, yeah. All right, thanks. And he put the phone down and I went, what were you going to say that you didn't say at the end? And you went, I was going to ask him for a layer of English and a layer of French mustard. And since that day, Pete's...
I love mustard, though.
There we go. I find that working with this lot, I don't know, it's perhaps the steadiest thing that's happened in my whole life.
And if it rains all day, call on you, I'll call on you, like I used to.
Me and Mark were the same year at the same sixth form college. I used to think he was a bit of a scrote, and he thought I was a bit of a hippie, and we were both right. He had like a bowl cut and like fat trainers and flared jeans, and I had long hair and
poncho,
shit trainers, and don't bring up the poncho. Mark heard me sing and then offered me a lift home one day. He saw me on the road. I often think about that. It's like, would have had a very different life if he'd have sneezed, or if there'd have been an attractive woman on the other side of the road. He would have missed me, not picked me up, and not asked me to join his band.
Speak fire thing and strung like a violin. I was yours was a face. With a grace from a different age. Well, you were the sun of my Sunday morning. You were the sun of my Sunday morning. Telling me never to go. So I'll live on the smile and move.
the last voice.
I still get this feeling when we're playing that if I walked off the stage, it'd just keep going out me. I suppose it's that old thing about the whole being greater than the sum of the parts.
No one knows.
I don't remember any cinematic decisions to do it for as long as we've done it or anything like that. It's just, why would you stop?
Hoosier is next, their brand new vid.